Hey there, my name is Dan Scott, and this is one video from my larger Adobe XD course, which you can check out on bringyourownlaptop.com. You can also go there to download the free exercise files and the free cheat sheet if you like. All right, enjoy the video. Okay, so in this video, we're going to look at building the iPhone version or the app version of our product. Okay, and then we'll link it all up so it kind of slides next to each other. All right, let's go and build this now. We've been working with the wireframes for the templated wireframes from XD for the web. Okay, so we want to go and open up the ones for mobile. Okay, so in your exercise files under UI templates under wireframes, there's one in there called mobile. Open them up and same sort of thing, but obviously for mobile screens. Okay, so to get started, okay, I'm looking for like an onboarding type thing. Do they even have an onboarding thing? They do. Cool. So it's that kind of thing when you open up the screen and there's that kind of like next, skip, you know, just to kind of give you a bit of an overview of the product. Then my wireframes, my hand-drawn ones here, we've kind of gone through some onboarding, then some login, and then you get to see the dashboard. Cool. So I'm going to pick one of these. And what I might do is grab this one, because what I really actually want, I don't want much of this. I'll take you and I'll take this bit. Okay, and I want this and I want this. Yeah, that's the bits I want. So I'm gonna copy that and I'm gonna jump over to my, I'm gonna close the wires for web. Don't need him at the moment. So just my project and the app version. So I'm going to work on the mobile phone version. I'm going to click on the artboard tool and I'm gonna pick the iPhone 6S. Okay, I'm gonna grab the dotted line. When you zoom out far enough, see you can't see the name, it just becomes three little dots. You can drag those around. And where am I gonna start them? I'm gonna start them as a new little line along the bottom here. So I'm gonna zoom in, command 3. Okay, zooms into a specific place, whatever you've got selected. So I'm gonna hit paste here and jackpot. What I might do as well is actually I'll do some edits and then I'll go and commit it to a symbol. So this one's gonna be called Instructor HQ. Okay, and yes, this is all good. So I'm gonna grab all of them actually and just chuck them into a symbol. So you select them, symbol. Awesome. And I'm just going to put some dummy text in the middle here. This is going to be an exciting onboarding message. This is going to be number one. Okay. And you are going to go in. I'm going to use that big version I've got. Cool. And I'm going to do the tiniest bit of design work. Okay. I know I shouldn't, but I liked that circle that I saw in the last one. So break the rules. That's what they're there for. Oh yeah, Dan, you've made it super exciting. I don't know why I did that. Okay, but that's gonna be my super exciting onboard message one. And there's gonna be, let's just do 3 of them. So I'm gonna double click this, double click it again. You can kind of get in there pretty easy by double clicking. Select all 3 of these, put them in the middle. And then remember, I can click on them and say, right click, update all symbols. Even though I haven't used it again, I'm just updating the one here in my library. Great, so I want, how many of these? I want 3. So I'm gonna hold down, I'll name them first. Okay, this is gonna be my app. And this is the onboarding number 1. Get people excited before they sign up or have to log in, because that's the worst thing, is like, hey, commit to a sign in. Whereas what we wanna do is say, hey, before you sign in, let's look at all this cool stuff you can do. Okay, so this is number 1, this is gonna be number 2. And just so the user knows when they are prototyping, or at least the client knows, we're gonna just change colors so that we know what we're doing. Go, and one more. My little lines, there they are. And you're gonna be message number 3. Number 3. And you can be that blue. We're running out of colors. We've only got 2 colors really, don't we? All right, so let's go back to the blue. Awesome. So we've got 3 of these, and that's gonna be my onboarding. What we might do next is do our prototyping, because we want to actually check the cool way you can view this on an app. So before we do that, we need to kind of make these buttons a little easier to click. So like we did earlier, okay, I'm going to select on this. I'm going to double click it. So that's why I know I'm inside it. See this kind of green bar on the outside? I know I'm inside my symbol. I'm going to grab the rectangle tool and I'm going to have a fill of white. Oh, I got something selected. Don't do that. Undo. Okay, I'm still inside. I can see the green bar. I'm going to grab you. I'm going to draw out a nice big box. You can kind of see I'm still in there because look, watch when I drag it. See that green bar around the outside gets bigger. I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to copy it and I'm going to send it to the back. Now, right click, send to back works. Okay, I'm using a shortcut and you can kind of see the shortcut there. It's Command Shift, the square brackets, which is next to the P key. I use that all the time because it's the same in InDesign, Illustrator, and Photoshop, which is nice. There's my big white box, so it's going to be easy to click. I'm going to copy it. Okay, and over here, I'm going to double click, so I know I'm inside the green thing. I'm going to paste it, move it to the back. Grab this guy, double click it, so I know I'm inside the green thing. Paste it, move it up, send it to the back. Maybe make this one just a touch smaller. It's getting quite big. Copy him. And I don't have one over there. Cool. So I'm going to click off on the background, click it once. I've got it selected. Okay, got this whole kind of group that I made. And remember, update all symbols. And hopefully now over here, when I double click it, there's that box. Awesome. So symbols are great because it means when we go and now do prototyping, I've got nice big boxes to click. Okay, so let's rig this up. We're going to grab the next box. And I'm going to say when you are clicked going there. And by default, it's been going to dissolve. Okay, and now that we're in a more kind of like mobile centric world, we're gonna look at slide to the left. Okay, so yeah, we'll have a look at this when we preview. And what we might do just to show you the difference is we're going to go to this version and we'll look at the other one, which is push left. Okay, and just see the differences between them. So next. And this one here's got nowhere to go to. So what I might do is actually just grab another board. And we'll make this one the app. And it's gonna be the login screen. We won't actually build this at the moment. So we'll just delete everything on this page. Goodbye. And at least this has got somewhere to go to now. Grab the white box. You're gonna go there. Okay, it's gonna be the same for these skip buttons. I'm gonna say you go there. I want you to go there. So we're skipping, we're going all the way to the login. That didn't connect. Okay, and skip here is the same. Can't see it. That's why it's easy just to go here and go login. That's why naming them is quite useful, I said at the beginning. All right, so that's them done. What I might do is I want to change these dots to move through, but I'm not going to bother. I should because I want to, but because there's a wireframe, we're just going to go quick. The back buttons need to work. Okay, and so I'm going to grab this guy, go to prototype. And you, my friend, go back to you. And you, go back to you. Okay, and a little bit of a flaw in my symbol making. Okay, it means that, these two work, but there's an arrow that doesn't go anywhere here. So I'm probably just gonna ignore it, or I can select on, go to my design, click on this thing, which is, see it green around the outside here. I can ungroup the symbol, which is not great, but I need to in this case. Okay, so goodbye. Goodbye. I potentially have the same problem with these dots if I wanted to update them. Okay, I got a little bit carried away with my symbols. I was impressed when I said it. All right, so what we want to do now is some testing on mobile. So we're going to jump to the next video because there's a cool little app you can download and we'll look at that now. Hey there, please like the video. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel as well. If you want the full course for Adobe XD, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. That's it. Bye now.